You are always before me, Almighty God. Hallelujah. God bless you, Teresa. God bless you, Teresa. All I know, you are always there for me. Today, Jesus been here today too. Hey, if you be a man, do more. Thank you.
Good morning, Millicent. Good morning, Teresa. Good morning to you all. God richly bless you for joining Hope of Glory Network Radio, Hope of Glory Network TV on Facebook, Hope of Glory Network Prayer Line, Radio Afronovia from Sweden. Good morning to you all, Radio Afronovia from Sweden. Continue our morning program of Bible teaching and preaching and prayer. So don't go away. Stay tuned and call your friends to join us here on Facebook Live. Your pastor this morning is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Shrenkansa, Maryland, United States of America. God richly bless you. Mm-hmm. Welcome on board Radio Afronovia from Sweden. God richly bless you. Brother Alex from Sweden. Reverend Sedba, God richly bless you, my apostle. Dr. Sedba, God bless you for the music. Good morning to you all this morning for joining Hope of Glory Network TV on Facebook, Hope of Glory Network Radio, Hope of Glory Network Prayer Line. God richly bless you for coming. We're going to pray. We're going to share the word of God. Don't go away. Call your friends to join us. Stay tuned and God richly bless you. Your pastor this morning is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Shre Nkansa, Maryland, United States of America. Let's keep on continuing. Let's do this one too. Hey. This is Seth Frimpong. I don't know. If I can get some of my people on board. Yes. I'm the one that God has blessed me. You see how God has blessed me here by the grace of God. I'm so blessed by the grace of God in Jesus' name. To the glory of the Almighty God. I want to pray with you. I want to pray with you this morning in Jesus' name. Jesus said we should pray without ceasing. So we're going to pray. Right now we're going to pray. Let me see if I can reduce my music here to continue with you. So we're going to pray. I want to pray with you. Shall we begin to pray and thank the Lord? Thank the Lord with me. Give glory, praise to the Lord for giving you the opportunity to see another day, to giving your life back to you in Jesus' name. God has given your life back. He has given you freedom to move, to go, and to come. Yes, to move your hands and your legs around It is the Almighty God. When you go to the hospitals, there are some people there, they cannot do anything. Some people in their homes, they cannot even eat. They have everything. They have like a 5-bedroom, 6-bedrooms. Some of them have store buildings. Some of them have money at their banks, but they can't use it. They can't do anything with it. Here in the United States, I go to hospitals, I go to places, and I see how people are suffering, how people want to live life, how people want to speak, how people want to walk, how people want to feel their fellow human beings, but they are not able to do it. By the grace of God, you are here alive. You slept last night, and this morning you have been waked by the grace of God. You have freedom of speech. You do everything. You breathe everything. You speak for free. Let's begin to thank the Lord and give Him glory. Begin to praise the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you this morning. Father, we bless your name in Jesus' name. We glorify your name, my God and King. I thank you for this special morning. I thank you for every soul that is with us in prayer, that has met with us this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, yes, our Lord and King, our Savior, we thank you and we pray. We thank you and we pray. We thank you for our homes, for our friends. We thank you for our family. We thank you for everyone. We thank you for what you have done. We thank you for all that you continue to do. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hear our Lord and King for the healing. Oh, for the healing. Yeah, we have been healed of our diseases. You have delivered us from the camps and the hands of our enemy. We are so blessed this morning. Yes, we are so blessed this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus, we praise your name, Jesus. We praise your name, Jesus. We thank you for our friends. We thank you for this fellowship. Sister, it is just by the grace of God that you have joined us. Yes, Satan did not want you to be here, but by the grace of God, you have joined us. We thank God for your life. I thank God for your family. I thank you for everything in your life. I tell you that you are so wonderful and special, brother. You are so special, sister. And God loves you. I want you to understand that. That is why I want you to continue to join me in praising the Lord God Almighty. In the mighty name of Jesus, shout hallelujah and say glory be to the name of the living God. Shout hallelujah and say praise be to the name of the living God. Shout hallelujah and say, God, we thank you in Jesus' name. My God, faithful God, almighty God, we thank you for all the people from all walks of life, all people from different nations that have joined us, all people from different places that have joined us, all people of different color that have joined us, in the mighty name of Jesus, because you are a God that do not cease to do miracles. You do not cease to do miracles. You continue to take care of your children. So we have every reason to praise and give you glory. We have every reason to thank you for your faithfulness, for your goodness, for your power, for your presence. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. God is good. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. I want to pray with you. I want to pray with you. And I want you to pray and commit yourself to the Lord this morning. I don't know what you are doing. I don't know what you have done before. I don't know what may be a hindrance between you and your God when it comes to sin, when it comes to disobedience. We should come to the Lord, or when we come to the Lord, we need to ask the Lord to forgive us. We need to ask the Lord continuously to cleanse us by the power of the blood of Jesus. Shall we continue to pray and ask the Lord to cleanse us by the blood of His only begotten Son? Shall we pray? Pray for somebody. Pray for your family. Pray for your pastor. Ask for forgiveness for your leader, for our leader, for your husband, for your wife, for your children. In Jesus' name, my God. I ask for forgiveness in the mighty name of Jesus. I ask for forgiveness. I ask for forgiveness for myself. I ask for forgiveness for my family, for my fellowship members, for my church members. I ask for forgiveness for my pastors, for my senior pastors, for my young pastors, for my leaders, for the people of my community. In the mighty name of Jesus, by the power of the blood, cleanse every one of us. Forgive us and do not count our sins against us. My God, do not count our sins against us. Jesus, do not count our sins against us. Father, do not count our sins against us. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hey, yeah. Mandara broski toro broshala batayaba. Father, forgive every sin, every iniquity. Forgive us this morning. Forgive us and heal our diseases. Forgive us and separate us from sin from today. Every sin that has hold on us, every sin that Satan, capitalized on it against us, we ask for forgiveness this morning. We ask for forgiveness this morning. Every sin that stands as a stumbling block against our success, we ask for forgiveness. My God, forgive me. Jesus, forgive every one of us. Oh, our Lord, forgive every one of us. Every echanic sin, clear it from our blood. Clear it from our system. Every ancestral sin. Jesus, just have mercy on us. Have mercy on us and forgive us. We give you glory. We thank you for forgiving us. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Amen. You know, there is something that I need this morning. There is something that you need. Let me tell you, if you get to the level of that need or that anointing, I'm telling you, you have end your struggle. That is what I want to tell you. If you get to that level of grace, I'm talking about grace. You need the grace of God this morning. I need the grace of God this morning. You see, when you have the grace of God upon your life, every man that sees you like you, every woman that sees you like you, every human being that sees you, they like you. Not that they like you because of sexual things, but they just like you. You just found favor of men. Let me tell you, you need the favor of men. When God causes the favor, divine favor upon your life, you will not struggle in life, I'm telling you. You will not struggle to marry. You will not struggle financially. You will not struggle to get healed. You will not struggle to get child. You will not struggle to go through anything. When you go to interview, if you are 10 people, they will choose you because of the favor of God. They say they will choose you. Hey, I need the favor this morning. Can somebody pray with me that the Lord will release the anointing of favor? The Bible said the favor of God was upon Daniel. The favor of God was upon Esther. And you can read the story of Joseph. You can read the story of Esther. You can read the story of Daniel. The Bible says Daniel have, excellent favor of God. I need the excellent favor of God. Shall we begin to pray for the favor of God? Excellent favor of God, Jesus. Whoa, yeah, yeah. Bereke manda ya ya ya, erege bro zindara bada bro bo ya ya, bayari ande bro ke bro bro diva, le mama, in the mighty name of Jesus, le manda bro ge le bro yanda braya baba, le rabo bro zindele bebe ya ba, bayari abo roski moro suri ande braya, my God and Lord, I need your favor, I need your favor in every area of my life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, cross me with excellent favor. Hey, cross me with excellent favor. Hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. I need favor. Hey, in every area of my life. I need you, my God. I pray, release favor from heaven upon my life. Release favor from the north, favor from the west, favor from the east, favor from the south, favor from behind me, favor from before me. In the name of Jesus Christ, let me walk in favor. Let me take my steps in favor. Everybody that comes in my life will find favor because I am favored. In Jesus' name, I need divine favor. Father, we need divine favor to catapult us, to take us higher. We need divine favor. As we pray, we ask for divine favor. We ask for divine favor for every woman, for divine favor for every family, divine favor for every couple, divine favor for every student, divine favor for every woman, divine favor for every man, divine favor for every pastor, divine favor for our nation as a whole, divine favor for our leaders, divine favor for our students. In the name of Jesus, oh, open the windows of heaven for excellent divine favor. Yeah, I say excellent divine favor. The devil rekenda rabba, yeah. Makile maraya. Sisters and brothers, let's begin to walk in divine favor. Excellent favor of God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, let's soko brayan darababa. Mari indobroka ya. Aye. Moriandalaba. Rosku no riandalaba. Jesus is good. Jesus is good. Jesus is good. Can you sing this song a few minutes and then we continue with the word of God? Just dance wherever you are as we continue. And they are an American. Today, and never yet, and Juma, and never yet, and training. Today will be miracle, a day of miracle, a day of miracle. Today is a day of miracle, sisters and brothers. Whether Satan likes it or not, God has ordained miracle today for me and you. I say, God has ordained miracle in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Amen. Jesus' name. Amen. God has ordained miracle for somebody today. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes. So now, let's go to the word of God by the grace of God. Let's go to the word of God in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Precious brothers of God, blessed children of God, let's go to the word of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. What is making noise? What is making such a noise? In Jesus' name. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. My God, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. You see what is on your screen. I say that Jesus Christ will fight for you today. He will fight for you. Your life will never be the same. Your life will never be the same by the grace of God. By the grace of God, your life will never be the same in Jesus' name. You know, when God starts something, He will accomplish it. When God starts something, He makes sure He finishes all that He started by the grace of God in the name of Jesus Christ. And I want you to understand that whatever God has started doing in your life, no demon will be able to stand against it. No power of demon of darkness can stand against it. They cannot stop God from what He has started doing in your life. Because what God has started today, He started it before the creation of this world. God started doing that miracle, that wonderful things in your life before the foundation of this world, before God created this world. Yes, He ordained to bless you. He ordained to deliver you from the hands of your enemy. And this morning, I am here to tell you that you are so much blessed that you need to see it. You need to pray for God to open your eyes. And God is on your side. Somebody say, God is on my side. I know and I believe that God is on my side. Let me tell you, I believe God is on my side. Yes, I believe God is on my side. And what God is doing on my side, oh, is so marvelous. You need to see it. You need to see it. That is why this morning I'm telling you that God will fight all that you are going through. He will fight your problem. He will fight your enemy. God will fight your enemies for you. Hey, the battle is not for the swift. The battle is not for the rich. The battle is not for the beauty. It's not for the handsome. It's not for the educated. The battle is for those that God wants to have, like you. Hallelujah. The battle is for those that have been blessed by the Almighty God. Those that have been blessed under the anointing of Jehovah. Yay, that is what I'm talking about this morning. And I want you to understand that you have been so much blessed under the anointing, the unction of the Almighty Jehovah God. You have been so much blessed. Sister, you have been so much blessed that nothing can stop the blessings of God. I say nothing. Somebody say nothing with me. So turn your Bibles to the book of 2 Chronicles, 2 Chronicles chapter number 32, verse number 8. Chapter 32, verse number 8 of the book of 2 Chronicles. 2 Chronicles, 2 Chronicles chapter number 32. Hallelujah. God is so good. Oh, God is so good. Can you say all the time, God is so good? Yes. He's so good all the time. Hallelujah. My God, my God, my God, my God. So, in the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 32, verse 8, it talks about Hezekiah. Let's see. It talks about Hezekiah and a particular king of Assyria called Sennacherib. So, with him is an arm of flesh. But with you, or with us, is the Lord our God to help us and to fight our battles. And the people were strengthened by the words of Hezekiah the king. You see, understand what we are going now, where we are going now. This king has been threatening the children of Israel under the kingship of Hezekiah. He has been threatening them, and the Bible says at a point of time, he wrote a letter and gave to his general to go and give to King Hezekiah just to put them in more fear, just to put the children of Israel in more fear. I don't know what you are going. I don't know what you see. I don't know how you feel the gravity of your problem. Maybe everyone has his own problem. Some see their problem very tall. Some see their problem very low or small, but still, maybe that same still small problem might see very difficult for you to handle, and you don't know how to handle it or how to go about it. So you are always in fear. You are in constant fear that it's not going to work. You always panic, and you always in stress, because you know at this time you're not going to get married. You know at this time you're not going to have your green card anymore. It has been too long. You know you have stayed with a man for a long time and no child. So you have even forget about it. I don't even think about giving birth. I hear some people saying that. And then other people say, I don't even think about marriage now. You will lie. You will think about marriage. Think about marriage. If you don't think about marriage, it will not come to pass. So think about marriage. As for me, I like the way I am. You like the way you are? So if you are so much blessed, you don't like it, you don't want more blessing, the Bible says that, and you shall receive more blessing, blessing upon blessing. You know, in the book of John chapter 10, verse 10, it says, the thief cometh to steal, to kill, and to destroy, but I come that you might have life and life abundantly. So don't just accept the life you are now. Accept the abundant life. Abundant life. Abundant life means overflow. Overflow. Superflow. It's flowing over. Let me tell you. That is why I'm telling you this morning, you don't have to live in constant stress, in constant worry, in constant fear that it's not going to work, because it will work for you by the grace of God. Because the fight is not your fight. Listen to the scripture this morning. You see, they come with all kinds of weapon of flesh. You know, sometimes when friends are telling you stuff, they don't think about what they are telling you, right? There is this young girl in nursing school, and then she was telling me her friends said they advised her to go and get a boyfriend who will take care of her and do everything for her, because one of the girls said her boyfriend is doing everything for her and taking care of her. And I asked her, how do you know the boyfriend that is not your husband will take care of you and do everything you want for you like the other girl's boyfriend? It's not like that. So these are the words of the armor of flesh that sometimes Satan releases against you. You look at your friends and you think that you are behind, and you think that you are a failure, and you think that life has disappointed you, and you think that nothing will work for you. And Satan begins to give you words of intimidation, words that will put you in a particular place where you will not see yourself as a beautiful woman anymore. You will not see yourself as somebody that God has blessed you. That is why this morning I'm telling you that all you are going through, just leave it to the God that we serve. The God Almighty, the God of Abraham, He will take care of you. God has already taken care of your situations. Hallelujah. God has already taken care of your situations, your problems, your anxiety, all your worries. God has already taken care of it. You know, This is how the enemy continually threaten or threat Israelites. And the Bible says, when you read, King Hezekiah has nothing to do. I like this wonderful king. You can't use anything to intimidate him. I say you can't use anything to intimidate him. This army general tried to suppress him with words of intimidation. He did not accept it. He continued to hold his faith in God and was so much strong to encourage his followers. There was a time even a prophet of God came to prophesy over his life to put his house in order because he is about to die. This man says, I will not die today, I will not die tomorrow. I have more things to do for the Lord, so I'm not going to die. The Bible says this man started praying all kinds of prayer. He prayed the prayer of deliverance. He prayed the prayer of healing. He prayed the prayer of protection. And God said, I have listened to your prayer. And you know what? God sent the same prophet who went and prophesied that he's going to die. Then go and prophesy again and tell Hezekiah, I have added 15 more years to his life. God has added another year, more years to your life. You will live long, praise the Lord. How long did your father live before he died? Last Sunday, when I was preaching, I told the people that I am older than my father, and they laugh and laugh and laugh. And I said, you don't understand that I say I'm older than my father. You don't understand that I say I'm older than my father, and I explained to them, the reason why I say I'm older than my father is because my father died at very young or younger age than I am. Right now, the age that I am as a human being living, I'm older than the age that my father lived on earth. That is why I say the sickness that killed my father will not be able to hold me captive. So I don't have to be afraid. God is on my side. The sickness that killed your mother will not destroy you, will not be able to capture you. Because he that is in you, he that is behind you, is greater than the one that is coming with the flesh of arms. You see, in chapter number 32, verse 8 of the book of Chronicles, 2 Chronicles, it says that, with him, with Sennacherib, the army general that is coming, he is coming with an arm of flesh. He is coming with arm of flesh. But our weapon, the Bible says, we are not struggle or fight or fighting against physical things. We are not fighting against. We don't care about physical things. When people stand and they accuse us physically, we don't care about that. When they tell us that, oh yes, we are grown up, that is the physical thing they are talking about. We don't care because we see that in a spiritual realm, I look a very young guy. Hallelujah. I look very young, handsome guy. If you see me as an old guy, I see myself as a young, handsome guy. I see you in the spiritual realm as a young, beautiful lady there. Praise the Lord. Do not let Satan. Do not let Satan and his demons to put you in fear or in constant fear by telling you stories, by telling you that you cannot get married, by telling you that you cannot give birth, by telling you that, hey, this sickness is going to kill you. You're going to die. It is the same thing that killed your mother, your grandmother, your uncle. It doesn't matter. You are out of it. You are not part of them. You are part of Jesus Christ. You are blessed in Jesus Christ. And God will continue to see to it that you are more blessed and live a good life by the grace of God. you will live a life that will take you to heavenly places, that will take you to heaven with Jesus Christ. You will not live a life that will lead you to hell. Hey, manos, you in the name of Jesus Christ. From today, begin and decide to live a life that will lead you to heaven. Praise the Lord. When you live a life that leads you to heaven, yes, your bodyguards are the angels of God. They will fight your fight. That is why God says that He will fight your battle for you. You will not fight the battle. You will not fight the battle. Yes, one time when Moses and his people, or when he was coming after the deliverance from Egypt, they came to a place where they did not know what to do anymore, where they couldn't go forward, and they couldn't go behind, and they couldn't go, oh yes, on the sides, because there were mountains on their sides, and then there is sea before them, and the enemy is coming behind them. They were so much fearful, so much fear, so much fear gripped the children of Israel. They started casting some war of words against Moses. You see what you have done. Even if we have died in Egypt, that could have been better for us, because they would have a place to bury us. Here, if we die, who is going to bury us? Moses. Then God strengthened Moses. He said, Moses, tell the children of Israel to move forward. I want you to move forward. I don't want you to stand here and continue to complain and continue to be in fear. The battle is not your fight. The war is not your fight. I want you to see and understand today the salvation of the Lord God Almighty. Help me, God. How, God, I can deliver you from the hands of your enemy. Sisters and brothers, I just want you to understand how God is able to deliver, how God is able to heal, how God is able to provide, how God is able to open the windows of heaven, how God is able to pour favor for people. I'm telling you, when God's favor comes upon you, your enemies will run away. This morning, your enemies will run away. Whoever that is chasing you in the spiritual realm, they will run away, because God's angels have started fighting them. God's angels have started fighting whoever is fighting you. So the war is not your war. The battle is not your battle. All you need to do is begin to call upon the name of the Almighty God. Hey, the God of hosts, the God of miracles, the God of war. He is the one that fought against this king and his people. The Bible says while they were still talking and releasing words of intimidation, they're releasing words of arms of flesh against King Hezekiah. Hey, a messenger came and announced to him, there is war in your country. And if you don't go back, before you get back, your country or behind you will be destroyed. Your family will be destroyed. Your men will be destroyed. So it's better you stop this war and go and fight the battle in your country. So the Bible says, hey, at a time, the same moment, this man and his soldiers, they left the place. They left King Hezekiah, and there was no more. God has finished the war. God will finish your war. He will finish your battle. He will finish your struggle. He will finish whatever you are going through. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I say your struggle has come to an end. Like the struggle and the fight that were confronted the children of Israel came to an end. At a particular moment, all of a sudden, there was an announcement. There was a messenger. A messenger is coming to announce to your enemy to go back. They will go back, whether they like it or not. They will go back, and your freedom is about to be announced. Your deliverance is about to be announced. It is today. It is right now. It is time for your miracle. Jesus is coming. Yes, He's coming with miracle in your life. Jesus is coming with miracles in your life. That is why you need to receive Him. Receive Jesus Christ now as your Lord and personal Savior. Hey, yes. and you're going to see the manifestation and the power of his death and his resurrection that is upon your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Can you say amen to the glory of God? Hallelujah. Amen. God is good. You see how God, you see how God did to save the children of Israel. I want you to read the whole scripture of the book of Second Chronicle, chapter number 32, and you're going to see how the story unfolded, how the messengers came and they announced, or they came to inform the army and their general that there is a war. So he has to go back, and he returned without fighting King Hezekiah anymore, because King Hezekiah has already received a message from the Lord that the war or the battle is not his fight. The fight is not his fight. It's not you to struggle. It's not you. You see, yesterday, the whole day I've been watching a Ghanaian movie, and this Ghanaian movie, a particular Ghanaian movie that I was watching yesterday, the title is Okono Nyawoko. And this is the woman that has been married to a man for a couple of years, and they don't have child. And the sister of the husband and the uncle of the husband has been worrying this man that they need a child. They need a child. You are the only brother like me. I have 10 sisters, 10 good sisters, wonderful, beautiful one. I'm the only guy like me. So they need their niece. They need their niece. So they keep on bothering the brother. And then all they decided is that now the sister of the brother said, I'm going to stay with them in their house. So she and her brother came to the house to stay with them for some time and started torturing the woman in words, started doing all kinds of things to increase the stress of this woman in the house, in her own house, in her own husband's house. And I was listening to the movie on the television. I said, I know Aguna people cannot do this to me. My sisters, my 10 sisters, none of them can do this to me. And I don't know the men that their sisters do that to them. Because it is not your fight. Like I told one sister one day, this sister has been telling this young lady and this young man trying to torture them, when are you going to give birth? When are you going to give birth? And it happened in front of me one time, and then I asked the lady, do you think that giving birth is like going to Walmart store and start picking up stuff? It's not like that. It is God's own time. God is the one that gives children. God is the one that gives deliverance. So you don't want to bother yourself, worry yourself. All you need to do is to strengthen your faith and keep on praying. Rely on God and trust only in him. And he will fight your battle like he did for Hezekiah. So sisters and brothers, I don't know what you are going through, what you have been facing before. I don't know how you feel the problem that you are going through. Yours might be finances, financial difficulties. Every day you have a problem to solve in finances. Every day you have a bill to pay. You paying school fees, and that is not easy for you. Maybe yours might be marital problem. You and your husband are so struggling. Every day there is a fight in your house. The man doesn't respect you, or the woman doesn't respect you. This is what is going on in your life, in your marriage. It's a hell for you. Sister, that is not your fight. It is the fight of the Almighty God. All you need to do is to trust the Lord to change that situation in your marriage. I just want you to understand that God is more than able. He can solve and he can do everything at his own time. You see, you don't force God, but you pray to God to have mercy in the situation that you are going through. And God is so merciful and wonderful. He listened to every sincere prayer. Hallelujah. According to Psalm 37, before we close, let's take that psalm from Psalm 37. Let's read that quick before we close. The Spirit of the Lord has just dropped that scripture to my heart to read with you before I close, by the grace of God. Psalm 37. Psalm 37 says, "Do not fret because of evildoers, nor be envious of workers of iniquity, for they shall soon be cast down like the grass. Trust in the Lord and do good." From today, that is verse number 3. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land, that is, dwell in the word of God. Dwell or live good life and feed on his faithfulness. Feed on the faithfulness of God. Be faithful to God. You are a Christian. Don't be a lukewarm Christian. Be a faithful Christian. And if you be a faithful Christian, God has already accomplished his path. Verse number 4 says, "Delight yourself also in the Lord, and he shall give you the desire of your heart." God will give you the desire of your heart. Verse 5 says, "Commit your way." If your ways are not good, if you are living lukewarm life, the Bible says, "Commit your ways to the Lord and then trust him." You see, trust him. Don't be like a doubting Thomas. Don't doubt God. Believe that God is able. He can accomplish everything. He can do it. And he has already finished for you. Keep trusting the Lord. When you get to verse number 25, let's jump to verse number 25 because of our time. Verse number 25 says that, "I have been a young man living in Krofa Bontenso. I was schooled in Krofa Bontenso and then continued school in Kumasi and in Asamankese and in Accra. All these places I have been a young man living there. And now I live in the United States. I have grown now. I have seen life. I have been in ministry as a pastor over 25 years. I'm not a child by the grace of God." But you know, in verse 25 of Psalm 37, it says, "I have been like I told you, and now I am old." You don't want to know my age. "Yet I have not seen a righteous or the righteous forsaken, nor his or her descendants begging for bread." That means, you see, when you serve God faithfully, God will be faithful to you. When you serve God faithfully without doubt and continually trust in him and be faithful to him, oh yes, Jehovah God will open the windows of heaven for your life. And I see God has opened the windows of heaven for your life right now. The windows of heaven in your life has been opened. It is you that you are not looking straight. It is you that you are not standing straight. You see, at times you look up and at times you look down. And you see, the time that sometimes you look down is the time that opened the windows of heaven open. And the angels of God that are delivering, they want to drop it so that you can hold it like this. When the blessing is coming or they are about to drop it from heaven, they see you like this. And God wants you to stand straight and lift your head up. In the book of Psalm 121, it says, "I lift up my head up towards the heaven. Where does my head come from?" So God wants you to lift up your head continually, straight forward like this all the time, not looking down. The moment you look down, the angels will take their blessings back. So from today, sisters and brothers, I want you to continue to look up there. Keep on looking up there. Your blessing will drop in your own hands. Begin to stretch forth your hands and be ready to receive it. Begin to stretch forth your hands and begin to receive it. Be ready for it now. If you'll be ready for it, God is about to drop it. God is ready to drop it right now. In the name of Jesus, sister, let me tell you, I prophesy and I declare in your life that from today, your husband is coming. You're going to meet your husband. It doesn't matter how far he is from you. God has ordained that man will come in your life. God has ordained that woman will come in your life. God has ordained that somebody is going to bless you with big money. I said, God has ordained that somebody is going to bless you with big money. In the name of Jesus Christ, God has ordained that a door is going to be open for you. A door has already been opened for you because you are a child of God, because you have eternal identity. You have eternal identity. Hallelujah. I say you have heavenly identity by the grace of God. That is why you need to claim all this and begin to stand confidently, boldly, without fear, and keep on praying to the Lord. May God richly bless you in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Somebody say amen with me. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus, you are so good. You are so good. Let's see what my God. Thank you, Jesus, for this morning. Thank you for everyone here. Thank you for the blessing. Thank you for the healing. Thank you for destroying our enemies. Thank you for sending them back from our presence in the name of Jesus. This morning, I commit every listener, every viewer, every member into your hands as they go out to work, they go out to school, they go out to where they are going. They are traveling mercies. We ask for traveling mercies. We ask for your mercies for everyone today in the name of Jesus. Bless and continue to bless them. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. God richly bless you, sisters and brothers. Your pastor this morning has been Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Trenkansa, Maryland, United States of America. The text for our morning message, this morning message, was taken from the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter number 32, verse number 8. We also read a reference from the book of Psalm 37, verse 1 to 5, and then verse 25. May God richly bless you. Tomorrow morning, I will see you again. Can we share the grace of God? The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. God richly bless you. Amen. Hey. Oh. Ah. I say bye.